Hello, today I would like to introduce the track on inclinometer localization module or device, which consists of inertial sensors, 4 accelerometers and 1 gyroscope. I will demonstrate capabilities of this device. First feature will be 3D mouse capabilities. I will move this in 3D space. The second feature which I will demonstrate will be vibration and shock resistant inclinometer. I will show the fast reaction of 1 millisecond. It is fully three-dimensional and does not depend on its orientation in the respect of the gravity vector or Earth. The third feature which I will show will be sensor loss has no effect, and in other words, sensor monitoring can be performed in real time. I will demonstrate how 3 accelerometers are disconnected and only 1 accelerometer and 1 gyroscope are left on the board, and this device is still capable to detect gravity vector position and be vibration resistant and shock resistant. And the last feature, but it is not the least, is that shock detection accomplished by this module exceeds sensor measurement ranges. Here I'm using 3G accelerometers which are capable to measure 3G accelerations, and I will show you that detection can be performed for much higher values than 3G. Right now I will demonstrate the software which will work with this device, and this window is dedicated for gyroscope, and in the beginning I will demonstrate 3G mouse capabilities. I will rotate horizontally clockwise, small rotation, bigger rotation, counterclockwise, bigger rotation, and then vertically, smaller rotation, bigger rotation, and then counterclockwise. As you see, it is capable of detecting 3D mouse movements. Next feature which I would like to discuss is gyroscope. Gyroscope produces in its measurements angle position changes, and we see that accumulating errors are quite negligible when we have a slow and clear motion. We practically have a clear and consistent view of what we do in 3D space, but if we have a complex motion, we can notice that the errors are accumulating and absolute angle position drifts in 3D space. We cannot depend on gyroscope. That is why in this module accelerometers are used for compensating gyroscope, and gyroscope measurements are used for compensating accelerometer values or estimates. And now I would like to introduce inclinometer. This inclinometer has a capability to measure gravity vector orientation to the surface of this board. Here I would like to explain that the top two circles are dedicated for sensor fusion result calculated by this module, and the bottom two circles are simply raw measurements from 4 accelerometers. 4 accelerometer measurements are average, and the result is presented in the bottom two circles. As you can see here, we have Y, Z, X and Z axis. X axis is this direction, Y axis is this direction, and Z axis is this direction. Under static conditions, we see that when the motion is slow and clear, everything is fine and our raw measurements are consistent with filtering result. But assume we have a measurement channel disruptions and we disconnect one channel of an accelerometer, and we see that a bias occurs in the output of raw measurements. And we can look at the top of the of this window, and we see that this bias did not have any effect to the result of sensor fusion filtering algorithm implemented in this device. Then I would like to demonstrate dynamic conditions, particularly three situations. We have a shock, abrupt dynamic change, and we have a hit to the table. We see sudden bias values which produce a noticeable bias when there is a hit to the table. Then we have parasitic vibrations, which are also correctly filtered at the top two circles. And then we have a noticeable shock, which can produce a drastic bias, a noticeable bias in the raw measurements, and that bias can generate unexpected results later when those measurements are used in other filtering techniques. Now I will demonstrate disconnections of accelerometers one by one. I'm disconnecting first accelerometer. As you see, our filter result still shows gravity vector position correctly. I'm showing its resistance against vibrations, shocks, and parasitic vibrations. Then I'm demonstrating the second disconnect, or the second accelerometer, and the third accelerometer. Currently, only one accelerometer and one gyroscope is being used in the filtering, because three accelerometers are lost. I disconnected their power supply, and we can see that those lost values are practically compensated by the known information from the remaining single accelerometer and gyroscope. And now I will demonstrate again vibrations, parasitic vibrations, smooth vibrations, and shocks. It is still shock resistant, and then abrupt dynamic changes. When I hit to the table, we see that it is capable to detect stably gravity vector position in respect of the surface of this device. And the last thing and feature which I wanted to demonstrate is this value. Here we see the maximum acceleration which happened during our experiment, and we see that this value 5.3 g exceeds our measuring range of each of an accelerometer, which is 3 g. This is one feature of our device and very important. Another thing which I would like to mention before I finish this demonstration is that compensation dependence or dependency between accelerometer and gyroscope is an implicit result of the sensor fusion method implemented in this device. I did not use any special means or thresholds to detect the sensor disconnect event. I implemented sensor fusion method in this device, and it correctly and stably localizes gravity vector orientation in the respect of the surface of this module. So today I demonstrated four main features of this device: 3D mouse capabilities, very fast reaction rate of 1 millisecond, shock and vibration resistance, sensor monitoring. I showed that sensor loss has no effect to the output of sensor fusion filtering algorithm implemented in this device, and I show that sensor measurement ranges can be exceeded when using this device. Thank you very much. Bye-bye.